All right, we now have on the line Philippine Armed Forces Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Felimon Santos Jr. General, welcome to the program. Happy New Year. Thanks for taking our call.
Yeah, Happy New Year, Karina, and good morning to everyone.
All right, so I want to begin with your very own assessment of the situation post the U.S. strike. What are your expectations? What are you expecting to happen based on your own assessment and your own intelligence reports?
Regarding the incident in Iraq, for the local scenario, I think we will not be affected too much except for our Filipinos in the area. We do not have any affiliation. Our local terrorist group has no affiliation with the groups in Iran. However, we have taken our security measures. We are monitoring the local terrorist group here in the Philippines. For whoever would express their cooperation with the Iran group.
Now, the president's order is very clear. He has tasked the armed forces of the Philippines to prepare its air and naval assets to evacuate and bring home our countrymen if and when open hostilities erupt in the Middle East that may endanger their lives. General, do you think that it has become inevitable that the hostilities that the president speaks of will erupt in the Middle East?
We are monitoring closely through our defense attaché in the nearby Middle East countries. But as directed by the president, we are prepared with all our air and naval assets in the event that the situation worsens.
But what kind of coordination are you doing now with your counterparts in the Middle East? Can you just swoop in and conduct evacuation procedures if the need arises?
We are coordinating through our Department of Foreign Affairs. Whenever the situation worsens and all the clearance for the passage of our military assets in the area.
Mm-hmm. But you know how it goes. It's really not that easy, especially when you talk about the livelihood of some of our countrymen who are there. They really don't want to leave unless it's too late. So how do you think this will happen? How massive will this operation be, General?
There will be some risk. There will be some. It will take coordination with other countries. But we are trying our best so that when emergency erupted, we could go there as soon as possible.
Mm-mm. As soon as possible. I mean, that's going to be the key here. But how soon can we deploy? Or are you going to have your assets deployed there as we speak so that in any case these open hostilities erupt, you can readily extract our countrymen from the area?
Yeah, we are monitoring closely and coordinating with the route that we have established and planned. We are really enhancing our plan on the evacuation scheme, on how to do it.
And would you know if other countries as well are having, you know, the same kind of coordination with their Middle East counterparts, not just the Philippines?
Yes, we are doing our coordination with our counterparts, especially with the Middle East countries. Of course, we will. One of our contingencies is to extricate our countrymen either to the safe place so that we could immediately extract them.
Yeah, but as you talk to your Middle East counterparts, do you know if other countries are doing the same?
The other countries?
Yes. The other countries that also have their own nationals there in the Middle East.
Yes, of course. They are also concerned with their nationals on how to extract them in case the situation will worsen.
General, because of the ties that bind the Philippines to the U.S., what possibilities are you preparing for as a result of that U.S. strike?
As of now, our ties with the U.S., with the Mutual Defense Treaty, it only covers the Pacific area.
But are you preparing for any eventuality that the Philippines may be seen as a target?
There will be some assessment that the if ever the war says the other parties like the Iranian just to have a revenge with the actions of the U.S. We are tightening our intelligence effort here in the Philippines, just augmenting some. If ever we are ready to secure the embassies of other countries involved. Mm-hmm. Here is the local scenario.
Yeah, so that is a concern of yours as well, that we may just be seen as a target.
We have to protect all the other foreign nationals here in our country.
Mm-hmm. Because of what has happened, are you also looking closely on the foreign terrorists that have found themselves here in the Philippines?
Please repeat the question.
Because of what has happened, are you closely monitoring the foreign terrorists that have found themselves here in the country? We know that there are a number of them right now.
Yeah, yes, of course, we are monitoring everything.
And no chatter?
We are monitoring everything. We're increasing our intelligence coordination with other countries, especially those embassies concerned with the incident.
All right, so just as a final question, General, when open hostilities do erupt, how soon can your assets be deployed there?
Hello.
General, when hostilities do erupt and the lives of our countrymen are placed in danger, how soon can you extricate our countrymen from the area?
I cannot say specific time frame. As of now, we are trying our best on the war situation. As of now, as directed by the president, we are prepared to utilize our available assets, and we are already prepared.
All right. We're going to have to leave it at that. Philippine Armed Forces Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Felimon Santos Jr., thank you so much for taking our call. Once again, Happy New Year to you.
Bye-bye.